MAT0018, review for test 3. This is the fraction part. So our first problem, we are adding fractions. Your rules for adding fractions, you have to make sure you have a common denominator. We do. So we go ahead and put that denominator in our answer. And then we combine on the numerators. They are the counters. You have to watch your signs. They are different signs. Different signs subtract, sign of the larger. There's nothing you can do here. You cannot reduce. Problem 2. Again, we are adding fractions. We make sure about the common denominator. We have a common denominator. So we'll keep it. Put it over in the answer. Combine on the numerator. These are like terms. They both have a y. So we work with the coefficients, 3 and 2, they're both positive. So we add, keep it positive, one copy of the variable. Problem 3, we are subtracting fractions. It's the same rules as addition. You make sure you have a common denominator, which we do. So we will keep it, put it in the answer. We don't do any math on that denominator. The next step is to combine the numerators. You have to watch out here because they're not like terms. The 1 does not have an x with it, so they can't really combine. The only thing you can do is write them on the same line, and that's all you can do to the answer. Problem number 4, we're going to find the LCD, or the least common denominator, for these two fractions. When the denominators are pretty big, the best method is to use the prime method. So we'll go that route. 25 is pretty big. So we'll break down to primes. That's step 1. 25 is 5 times 5. And 10 is 2 times 5. And now we'll pick our common denominator. You have to have every type of factor that is there. So we have 2s and we have 5s. You take it from the fraction where it occurs the most. So for our 2s, there's no 2s in the first one, 1, 2 in the second one. So we will need a 2 for the 5s. This one has 2 5s, the other one has 1 5. Take it from the fraction that has the most. So we're going to take it from the first one. The other one would divide into it. So we're going to have a 2 times 5 times 5. When you multiply that out, that's 25 times 2. Or 50. That is the least common denominator. Problem 5 is also to find the LCD. So we're only looking at the denominators, 18x and 21. These are also fairly large, so we'll go with the prime method. We first break everything to primes. We're not concerned about the variable, it's just an extra type of factor. So for 18, two things that multiply to give 18. We might see 6 times 3, and 6 gives us 2 times 3. Bring this 3 down, it's already prime, and I'm going to bring down the x. Now I have all primes. For 21, I have 3 times 7. So for my LCD, I need every type of factor that I have, and you have to take it from the one with the most. So I will need 2s, 3s, 7s and x's. For 2s, there's 1 2 in the first one, no 2s in the second one, so I will take 1 2. For 3s, the first one has 2 3s, the second one only has 1, so take it from the first one, 2 3s. For 7s, there are no 7s in the first one, 1 7 in the second one, so take 1 7. And you treat variables the same way. So for x's, there's 1x in the first one, no x's in the second one, so you will need 1x. And then we multiply this back together, which gives us 21 times 6, or 126x. For problem 6, we are actually going to do an addition and subtraction of fractions. The first job is always to find the common denominator. I would always test the biggest one and see if the other two divide into it. Five does go into 10, but 3 does not. So we can't go with 10. We'll have to go bigger than that. Anytime you have more than two fractions, the primes are good. So we'll go with the prime route. We're working on the LCD. 5 is already prime, 3 is prime, and 10 is 2 times 5. So we have to take every type of factor, 2s, 3s, and 5s. So our 2 will come from the last fraction. That's the only one with a 2. Our 3 will come from the middle fraction. And for our 5s, 2 of them have 5s, but they have the same number of 5s. So we have 1 5 here, no 5s, and 1 5. It comes from the one with the most, but these are tied. So you will only take it one time. This will multiply back together and be our LCD. So we have 15 times 2, or 30. Now, I'm going to go back and just move this piece so it won't be in the way. And for each one, I need to get a 30 underneath. So I'm going to bring down what I have, and I'm going to work on this fraction. I would like to get a 30 under here. What would I multiply by to get a 30? Just divide if you get stuck. So 5 into 30 will go 6 times. So I need to multiply by 6. Remember, you have to do numerator and denominator for it to be okay, because 6 over 6 is 1. So we'll multiply this out, gives us negative 12 over 30. I probably would drop it down, not put it after, because it'll be in the way if you put it after. Right, I'm going to bring the next one down. I'm looking at the denominator. I have a 3. I want a 30. What's missing on that one? Just divide. It's missing a factor of 10. 3 goes into 30 10 times. Do the same to the numerator. So I get 10 over 30. Bring down the last one. This time I have a 10 for my denominator, but I want a 30. You're missing a factor of 3 to multiply to get the 30. Do the same on the numerator and denominator. And that will give us a negative 9 over 30. Now we're set. We have the common denominator. Keep it and combine your numerators. You can just go across, or you can write them all together if you like. I'll write them so you can see them together. But we'll start across. Negative 12 and 10 is going to give us a negative 2 and a negative 9. Like signs. Add, keep the sign. And this is all over the original denominator. This will not reduce. For this problem, we are also subtracting fractions. The first thing I would do is I would make them both look like a fraction. And you can always make something look like a fraction if you put it over 1. So 4y over 1. Then we will find our LCD. Our denominators are 1 and 20. So the LCD, something they will both go into, is going to be 20, the bigger one. So we're going to have to work on the first fraction. We'll bring down what we have. We have a 1, but we would like to get a 20. So it's actually going to have to multiply by the 20, which will give us 80y over 20. The second fraction already has the 20, so I don't have to do any work on it. I can bring it all the way down. And now I'm set. I have the common denominator. Keep it, put it in the answer. Combine the numerator. These are like terms, so you can combine. They're different signs, so we'll subtract. Sign of the larger, positive. And keep your y. For problem 8, we're adding fractions. It's okay that there are 3 fractions. It's okay that they have variables. It's just fractions, and we're adding those. So, first step, make sure about a common denominator. If you check the largest one here, you can save yourself some work. Does everything divide into 16? 4 goes into 16? Yes, 4 times. 8 goes into 16? 2 times. So 16 will work. I would always test the largest one first. So 16 will be our LCD. We have to get that underneath. So we're going to bring down what we have. So bring down the x over 4 and check your denominator for what's missing. So if we have 4 and we want 16, we're going to have to multiply by 4. Do numerator and denominator. This gives us 4x over 16. We'll bring down the next one, x over 8. We have an 8 in the denominator. We would like a 16. It's missing a factor of 2. Put it on. Numerator and denominator gives us 2x over 16. Our third fraction already has the 16, so we can skip the middle step on it. Bring it down. Now we have a common denominator. Your rule is keep the common denominator and combine the numerators. And these all have x, so they're like terms. So 4x plus 2x is 6x, and 6x plus 2x will give us 8x. This problem actually will reduce. 8 and 16 have a common factor of 8. So you can divide by 8. 8 will go into 18 one time. 8 into 16 will go 2 times. So you have 1 times x, which is x over 2. If you write 1x over 2, that's okay. But x over 2 is simplified a little bit more.